Vegas. Viva Las Vegas.
Viva Las Vegas with your neon flashing and your one-arm bandits crashing all those hopes down the drain. Viva Las Vegas turning day into nighttime, turning night into daytime. If you see it once, you'll never be the same again. I'm gonna keep on the run, I'm gonna have me some fun.
Ayo, what is going on, everybody? Your boy Potter with Grandmaster Glass, your home for glass blowing. You can tell by the title, we're going to Glass Vegas 2024. Welcome back to the channel. Hopefully you're having a fantastic day. So something a little bit different though, the last two times I have been, I went in 2020 and 2023. I went as a spectating artist. This year I applied as media and I got accepted. So I will be having a media badge, being able to have access, take a bunch of cool videos, content. I have a lot of fun ideas that I've been thinking about. We'll see what I end up following through with. Some interviews would be really cool. Definitely gonna be shooting a lot of cinematic shots, getting a lot of B-roll footage, things like that. So we'll see how it all comes along. If you don't know what Glass Vegas is, I'm gonna spend a few minutes. I'm gonna flip the screen capture on it. I'm just gonna talk about it, show you a few things on the Glass Vegas website. But boy, I am excited. Also, a side quest with Glass Vegas. I have sent out my two creep pendants. I really love Creep Glass. His artwork, everything just really speaks to me. And I have two birds that sadly I have damaged. They have cracked. One of the birds, I nicked the beak. The other bird, the opal, cracked. So just nicked it. And he's actually going to repair it. He's going to be at Glass Vegas. So I'm actually going to be able to pick up the repaired pieces there. So I'll have my Schwangers back to rock around during Glass Vegas. So I think that's a pretty cool side mission, side quest. But yeah, let's turn this camera on and just talk about Glass Vegas for a second. So previous years, the event was actually at Bally's, which is now called the Horseshoe. They have moved it from the hotel, from Bally's / Horseshoe. They've moved it to the Las Vegas Convention Center. So this is actually going to be my first year going to the Las Vegas Convention Center. I know they have some other glass events at that location, so some of the artists won't be, it'll be familiar for them. But for me, I've never been there, so that will be a totally new experience. The dates are January 30th through February 1st, January 30th, 31st, and 1st, in the middle of the week. And, yeah, the event itself is closed to the public. It is a artist and buyer event. It is mainly to buy and sell glass. There are a few side activities. There is live glass blowing. There is a World Series of Glass. There are a few other side little small events that are associated with Glass Vegas. But for the main part of what Glass Vegas is, it's a buying and selling expo for glass art. And so that's exactly what it is. For the venue itself, massive, massive. There are so many artists listed. We're going to take a look in a minute here. And it just did some crazy zoom out. Here we go. Oh, what is going on? All right, so that's about good for zooming in. So you can just tell the overall volume. We're dealing with hundreds and hundreds of artists, different companies, people that are associated with the company, with the events. So some of these are companies. Some of these are just glass artists. Some are regular art. Some are glass art. Like that one right there, that's Mood Mat. So looking at the exhibitor list, I wish they kind of had just like a giant poster so you could kind of see them all at once. This is alphabetized, so if you know exactly who you're looking for or something along those lines. But if you don't want to see me just scroll through this entire list, you can just kind of click forward, fast forward. I'm just going to kind of point out all the ones that I'm hyped to see, some things that, you know, I'm going to experience so many new artists and things, but as far as what I know, I'm going to point out what I'm hyped to see. So just most notable people, AKM, that'll be nice. Andy G, know them. Then we've got, who else we got here? Banjo, Little Bear, Karma, Nady Love, Yushin. So they've got all, they all have a booth together. That's pretty rad. Then we've got, Bethlehem Burners. That's cool. That's a torch company. So they'll have a booth kind of showing off their products. Big Z Glass. That's what's up. Haven't seen much of his work here lately. Black Sands, Blitzkrieka. Then we've got... Actually, I'm going to try to use the... Oh, that's going to slide way too fast. Let's see. Continuing on. This is going to take a while. Bertone Glass. Then we've got C2 Customs. We've got Captain Chronic. Chad Lacey. Chaka. Dabrite, that's cool. Might check out their booth. Dab Towels, Danger Visual, and Coil, that's what's up. That's what's up. Dime Bags, that's a cool bag company. We've got Pelican in the house. Dopals, Dope Opals. Dr. Dabber, okay, all right. Dream Lab Glass, Drooby. Elbow in the house, that's what's up. That's what's up. Empire. Ethan Windy, Firefox, Glass X Wholesale Company, Glass Pass, that's interesting, Golden Gate, Hindi, Hex, Higdog, Hitman, iDab Tunes, that's what's up. J Smart. Jeff Heathbar. Joe P, that's what's up. Juju. KGB, got the donuts. Lace Face. Lurk. Matt A, Matt Robinson, Micro, Mood Mats, Mothership, Nico Cray, North Star, we got Glass Companies, that's what's up, Allure, Texas Native, Phil Siegel, Pinky, Puffco in the house, Quave, RL Dots, Roar, Ruby Pearl Co., Selfless, Skylab, Slugworth, Soup, Swanee, Topometer. That's interesting. Michigan Glass Project has a booth there. Weird. Interesting. Upgrade Glass. Windstar. Zong. Alrighty, bam. So that basically summarizes all the people that I know that kind of stood out to me that are going to be there. I'm going to find so many new companies, so many new artists, but that is kind of a rundown of what we're looking at for the actual event itself. Yeah, some of the pictures from last year, we've got like awards. So we've got paint demos, marbles, we've got after parties, the Millie meetup, we've got live music, the Boro Derby. There's also a photo booth, and also, there is a service where they're photographing all of these glass pieces while at Glass Vegas to get some really buttery, cool shots. So that's cool by Boro Vision. That's who takes all these photos for Glass Vegas, makes them look all nice and good looking there. So, yeah, if you want to check out some of the heady art from previous years, they've got a gallery full of that stuff. But yeah, just it's a whole lot of fun, whole lot of art under one roof. I've had a lot of fun, a blast the last two times I've gone. So the fact that this year going as a media artist, that's going to be so much fun. I'm really looking forward to it. I've got some friends that I'm hopefully meeting up with, linking up with there. A lot of people that are attending. I'm going to be hooking up with my homie Sherlock Holm. Hopefully I get to meet up with the homie Little Bear. We've got another hash homie. We've got Fully Meltable. We also have Cured Extract. So hopefully it's a good time. Put some smoke in the air and get some really cool content for you guys. Have a lot of fun with it. So hopefully you guys are hyped. I'm extremely excited to be sharing this adventure with you guys. And yeah, till next time, never stop evolving.